Seoul, Reuters, North Korea said it would reopen a long-closed border hotline with South Korea on Wednesday, hours after U.S. President Donald Trump appeared to mock the Nordha Euro trademark's leader by saying he has a Euro e bigger and more powerful a Euro nuclear button than Kim Jong Un. The Nordha Euro trademark's unscheduled statement, read out on state television, came a day after Seoul proposed high-level discussions amid a tense standoff over North Korea's Euro trademark's missile and nuclear programs. That followed Kim a Euro trademark's New Year a Euro trademark's address, in which he said he was open to speaking with Seoul and would consider sending a delegation to the Winter Olympics to be held just across the border in Pyeongchang in February. U.S. officials said Washington would not take any talks between North and South Korea seriously if they did not contribute to denuclearizing North Korea. A State Department spokeswoman said North Korea a Euro might be trying to drive a wedge of some sort a Euro. Kim gave an order to reopen a border hotline with South Korea at the truce village of Panmunjom at 6:30 GMT on Wednesday, said North Korean official Ri Sung-won. That gesture came only hours after Trump again ridiculed the North Korean leader on Twitter. A Euro will someone from his depleted and food-starved regime please inform him that I too have a nuclear button, but it is a much bigger and more powerful one than his, and my button works, A Euro Trump tweeted. While appearing to open the door to discussing taking part in the Winter Olympics, which would be the first direct negotiations in more than 2 years, Kim also sternly warned that he would push ahead with a Euro MS producing a Euro nuclear warheads in defiance of UN sanctions. His New Year a Euro trademark's day speech came after a steep increase in missile launches in 2017, as well as the Nordha Euro trademark's sixth and most powerful nuclear test. Kim, who has vowed to develop a nuclear-tipped missile capable of reaching the United States, said he had a nuclear button on his desk. A Euro serious and sincere a Euro trademark. The hotline with the South was shut down by North Korea in February 2016 in retaliation against the closing of Kaesong, a border factory town that was jointly operated by the two Koreas. A Euro detailed orders were given regarding setting up working measures with the South Korean government that should be taken up with a serious and sincere stance, A Euro said Ri, chairman of North Korea A Euro trademark's Committee for the Peaceful Reunification of the Fatherland, which deals with issues relating to South Korea. The talks would aim to establish formal dialogue about sending a North Korean delegation to the Pyeongchang Winter Olympics, Ri said. An official from South Korea A Euro trademark's Unification Ministry told Reuters they were ready to speak with North Korean officials once the hotline was opened. Government officials check the hotline, a telephone line at the border, twice every day in the morning and afternoon. South Korean presidential spokesman Yoon Young-chan said North Korea A Euro trademark's decision to open the hotline had a Euro e significant meaning ga Euro because it could lead to constant communication between the two Koreas. U.S. officials had voiced skepticism about the possibility of meaningful talks, particularly if they did not take steps towards banning North Korea a Euro trademark's nuclear weapons. Nikki Haley, the U.S. ambassador to the United Nations, warned North Korea against staging another missile test and said Washington was hearing reports that Pyongyang might be preparing to fire another missile.